Namaste students. In last class we have studied in detail about the external morphology and organ and organ system of leech. So in this class we are moving to the rabbit. So we have studied about the characteristic features of invertebrates, and now we are going to study about the characteristic features of vertebrate. In that rabbit we are going to study in detail. The scientific name of rabbit is Oryctolagus cuniculus. So Oryctolagus cuniculus. Phylum Chordata, subphylum Vertebrata, class Mammalia, order Lagomorpha, genus Oryctolagus, species cuniculus. So this is the taxonomic position of rabbit in animal kingdom. So habit and habited. Rabbit is a gentle and timid animal. They show leaping movement and lives in burrow. They are distributed throughout the world. They are herbivorous and feeds on grass and vegetables like turnip, carrot, lettuce. Rabbits are gregarious. Gregarious is they live and move in groups. So they are gregarious animals. So this is about the habit and habitat of rabbit. So now we are going to study about the external morphology. So external morphology is size, color and shape. It has an elongated and cylindrical body. Male and female are same sizes. It grows about 45 cm in length and weighs about 2 to 2.5 kg as adult. The color varies from white to black and white. So that is from white to black, in between brown, gray. So all these are different colors of the rabbit. So body is covered with fur which keep their body warm. So the next we are going to study about the body division. So the body is divided into different regions: head, neck, trunk and tail. So the first one is head. So head is ovoid, flattened and bear truncate snout. So the snout is truncate. The next is mouth, external naris, eyes, ears and vibrisse. So these are also seen in the head. So mouth is for eating, naris is for breathing and eyes is for visualizing, and ears is to hear the sound, and vibrisse are nothing but hair like structure which is seen in the upper lips, and it helps in the absorption of vibrations. The next one is mouth. So mouth is a transverse slit bounded by upper and lower lip. Above the mouth, oblique open called nostril. So through this nostril they will be respire oxygen. The next one, upper lip will have a tentacle ear, so that is called your vibrisse, and the movable external ear, pinna, is seen in the top of the head. So the head bears mouth, external naris, eyes, ears and vibrisse. So these are the things in the head. The next is the neck region. So neck is a short connective link between the head and trunk. So the neck connects the head with the trunk. So it helps to turn the head. The next is the trunk. The trunk is divided into two regions. Anteriorly it is called as thorax, and posterior region is called as abdomen. So the trunk is divided into two regions, that is thorax and abdomen. So now we shall move to the trunk. So trunk has pentadactyle limbs. Penta means five, dactyle is fingers. So each limbs will be having five fingers. So fingers are also called as digits. So the forelimbs are short than the hind limb. All digits have claws. So as we have nails, right? So the rabbits will be having claws. Next, in female, 4 to 5 tits or nipples is present on the ventral side between thorax and abdomen. So this is seen only in female. And then ventral slit, vulva is also present. So this vulva is helpful for the reproduction. So this is in female. In males, penis is present in the ventral side. A pair of testes enclosed by scrotal sacs. So in male, penis and scrotal sacs are penis testes are seen. In female, tits and vulva is present in the ventral side. So this is about in female and male. So the next one is anus is present in the posterior end of the abdomen at the base of the tail. So this is in common in both male and female. So the trunk will be having pentadactyl limb, that is 5 finger. So forelimb is short and hind limb is longer. In female, tits and vulva is present. In male, penis, testes and scrotal sac is present. Anus is present in the posterior end of the abdomen at the base of the tail. Next is the tail. So tail is short and it is in the posterior end. So the main function of tail is to give signals event of gender. So it will give signal to the other rabbits at the event of danger. The next one is integument. Integument is nothing but skin. So the covering of the body, the skin is the covering of the body. So it consists of hair, claws, nails and glands. So there are 3 different glands, sweat gland, sebaceous gland and mammary gland. So mammary gland is seen in females. It secretes milk to nourish the young ones. The sweat gland and sebaceous gland is seen in the skin. So it regulates the body temperature. So the integument consists of hair, which keeps the body warm, claws and nails, and it will be helpful for burrowing. So rabbit lives in burrow. So dig the burrows, these claws are useful. The next one is gland. Sweat gland and sebaceous gland helps to regulate the body temperature, and mammary glands will nourish the young ones. The next one is coelom. Coelom is nothing but body cavity. So all the mammals have 2 cavity, thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity. So thoracic is the upper region and abdomen is the lower region. So this thoracic cavity and abdominal cavity is separated by diaphragm. So diaphragm is the characteristic feature of mammals and it helps in breathing. So this, the shape of the diaphragm will change alternatively according to breathing. So while breathing, it will become dome shaped and flattened shape. So this alternation in position, that is dome and flatten, will aids in respiration. So the thoracic cavity. So the thoracic cavity will contain lungs and heart. And then abdominal cavity. So the abdominal cavity consists of digestive system and urogenital system. So this is about the body cavity in rabbit. So now we shall move to the system. The first system is digestive system. So digestive system is the combination of alimentary canal and associated glands. So here the digestive system consists of, that is, your alimentary canal consists of mouth, buccal cavity, pharynx, small intestine, stomach, pharynx, then esophagus, from esophagus to stomach, small intestine, cecum, large intestine, anus. And associated glands are gastric gland, liver, pancreas, saliva, and then intestinal glands. So this is your digestive system. So the food enters from the mouth and it reaches the pharynx. Through esophagus, it will reach the stomach. After reaching the stomach, digestion will be taking place and then it will move on to the intestine. So in intestine is the region where the absorption of food material takes place. And then cecum. Cecum is nothing but a blind sac. Here bacteria are present and helpful for digestion. And then after cecum, it enters the large intestine. So the undigested food will be excreted out through anus. So this is your digestive system. So we shall study in detail. The first is mouth. So mouth is a transverse slit bounded by upper and lower lip. So they are herbivorous and they will eat the grass and vegetables. So the food from the mouth reaches the buccal cavity. The buccal cavity has tongue, jaws and jaws bear teeth. So this is the things present in the buccal cavity. From buccal cavity it reaches the stomach through esophagus. So esophagus is a short passage and the food will reach the stomach. So stomach is the muscular region and digestion takes place here. So in stomach, hydrolytic and enzymatic digestion takes place. Hydrolytic is nothing but water, and then enzyme is the enzymes will react on it. So hydrolytic and enzymatic digestion takes place in the stomach. After digestion, the food will reach to the intestine. So in intestine, digestion absorption will be taking place. So in intestine also further digestion, and then the digested food will be absorbed. So intestine is divided into three regions: duodenum, jejunum and ileum. So the intestine is subdivided into duodenum, jejunum and ileum. From intestine it reaches the cecum. Cecum is nothing but a blind sac which is seen in the junction of small intestine and large intestine. So it contains bacteria and it digests the cellulose. So it has specific bacteria and it will digest the cellulose. So cellulose is nothing but the complex form of glucose. So the enzymes present in the digestive system cannot digest the glucose easily. So the bacteria present in this cecum will digest the cellulose and break down into glucose. And then the food material will reaches the large intestine where absorption takes place. Next, the undigested food will pass through the colon and rectum. So the large intestine has further divisions called colon and rectum. And then from rectum, the waste material will reach the anus and then it finally opens outside. So this is the process of digestion. Dentition in rabbit. Dentition is nothing but teeth arrangement. So how the arrangement of teeth is in rabbit. So teeth is nothing but hard bone like structure used to cut, tear and grind. So they are diplodont. So diplodont is nothing but two sets of teeth. So two sets of teeth are produced during the lifetime. The first set is milk teeth. Milk teeth is nothing but young teeth and permanent teeth in adult. So the milk teeth is replaced by the permanent teeth. So two sets of teeth are produced. So the teeth are heterodont. Hetero means different. So different types of teeth are seen. So what are they is incisors, canine, premolar and molar. So these are the different types of teeth present in a rabbit. So dental formula. Dental formula is nothing but expression in the form. So the expression of the teeth is called as dental formula. So this dental formula will contain teeth in upper and lower jaw on the one side. So it will only take account of one side of the teeth. So the dental formula of rabbit is I means incisors. Incisors is 2 by 1. 2 by 1 is in upper jaw it will be 2, in lower jaw it will be 1. C is canine. So canine is 0, 0. 0 means it is absent. The next one is premolar. Premolar means in upper jaw it is 3 and in lower jaw it is 2. Next one is molar. In upper jaw it is 3 and in lower jaw is also 3. And it is written as 2033 by 1023. So this is the dental formula of the rabbit. So this is only on the one side. So the other side will also have 2033 1023. So here the I said canine is absent, right? And it forms a gap. So that gap is called diastema. So it helps in the holding of the food very firmly. So since this gap is there, it can hold the food very tight and it is helpful for mastication and chewing. The next one is respiratory system. So respiration means it will be having two events. Inspiration. Inspiration is breathing in. Expiration is breathing out. Inspiration is the active process and expiration is the passive process. Exchange of gases. So the gases are CO2 and O2, carbon dioxide and oxygen. So during inspiration, the oxygen is taken out. During expiration, carbon dioxide is given out. So the respiratory system consists of external nostril, nasal cavity, pharynx, larynx, trachea, bronchi, bronchioles, and finally it ends with alveoli. So this is the lungs of the rabbit. So the main respiratory organ is lungs, and these are the different regions: larynx, trachea, bronchi, and then the lobes which contain alveoles inside it. Now respiratory organ. So the main respiratory organ is lungs. So lungs is a spongy tissue enclosed in the thoracic cavity. So the thoracic cavity will be having these regions. So in dorsally it is protected by vertebral column, ventrally by sternum. At the lower surface it has diaphragm. So you can see in thoracic cavity the lungs are protected. So you can see the vertebral column and then rib cage, and the center region is called the sternum and the lower region is called the diaphragm, and the lungs are protected inside this cavity. The lung is enclosed by double membrane cavity called pleura. So pleura gives protection to the lungs. So it prevents from mechanical vibration. So the process of respiration. Atmospheric air will enters the external nares and nasal passage and reach the pharynx. So the atmospheric air is taken in through the external nostril and nasal passage and it will reach the pharynx region. So through epiglottis it will reaches the windpipe. So epiglottis is nothing but a flap like structure which prevent the air from entering the food pipe. So this epiglottis acts as a guard, so which prevent the entry of food into the respiratory system and prevents the air from entering into the food pipe. So it prevents the passage of food and air in the systems. So here this epiglottis will prevent the entry of air into food pipe. Then from pharynx it reaches the windpipe through epiglottis. This windpipe is supported by cartilaginous plate. The anterior region of the windpipe will be having a larynx. So larynx is also called as voice box. So this voice box will produce vibration and vibration will produce sound. So vibration will produce a sound, and that's why this larynx is also called as voice box. The next region is trachea. So trachea is divided into two branches, that is bronchi. So see here, the anterior region of the windpipe will be your larynx and then trachea. So this trachea will be having C-shaped cartilaginous which gives the support. This trachea, that is, will divide into two regions, that is called your bronchi, and this bronchi is further divided into bronchioles, and this bronchiole will ends up in alveoli. So in alveoli oxygen is taken in and carbon dioxide is given out. So here the exchange of gases takes place. So this is about your respiration. Thank you, students.